Hi there guys, this is Nikhil from Greedy Tech. In this video, I am going to share with you some of the reasons that you might want to consider before buying a Mi Pad. So starting off with the price. Guys, for the price that they are selling in India, that is 13,000 rupees, which is 12,999, but let's round it to 13,000. So at 13,000 rupees, it is a beast of a tablet or a Mi Pad, whatever you want to call it. So it is a beast of a tablet for that price. So it comes with a quad-core Cortex A15 NVIDIA processors, which are really good, and apart from that they come with a 192 GPU cores which deliver amazing graphics performance. So apart from that, this device comes with 16GB internal storage, which should be pretty much if you are playing just small games, and which should be decently sufficient if you are playing 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 high-end games. And comes with 2GB of RAM. So out of the box, we get around 600 MB of free RAM. So as of now, there is only 400 MB. And now it just increased a bit. So moving on. So this device comes with a Retina display, which was actually termed by iPad, but it comes with around 2000 by 1500 pixel resolution and a 332 PPI. So the screen is really good. It looks really crisp, and it definitely comes close with the iPad mini, at least for the price we are paying. This is really a very good display, and let me just show you the brightness levels. So let me put it over here so that you can see the display more clearly in the camera. So going on to the next reason would be the battery. This device is powered by a 6700 milliamp hour battery, and the battery backup is really amazing. This is the best thing that I've seen after Nexus 7, and I've used other tablets like the Tegra 7 and the Samsung tablets, but compared to those devices, this device gives a lot of battery backup. If you're using it normally, then you can definitely expect around 2 to 3 days of battery backup, and even if you're playing high intensive games, you can definitely expect continuous 8 hours backup. So that's pretty good for a tablet, so at least for me. So going on, it comes with an expandable storage option, so you can upgrade the storage all the way to 128GB. So finally, the best thing is that you can root this device and still retain the warranty just in case if you run into any problems. And apart from that, this device has dual boot. So what it basically means is, it is pretty hard to break this device. Even if you mess something with the system one, you have system two as a backup. Just in case if you are messing with it and for some reason you bricked it, you can simply unbrick it by booting into the second system. So that is really one very nice feature, which I've seen it earlier in Mi 3. And none of the other phones, that is Redmi 1S or Redmi Note. So again, I am seeing that feature in this device. So guys, those are some of the reasons that you might want to consider buying this device. So let me just tell you some of the disadvantages, or just a few pointers as a caution. So this device comes with 16GB of internal storage, but you only have around 12GB of internal storage. That is for your apps. So apart from that, there is no GPS, and I don't think it's a very big issue. And just in case, if you are connected to a Wi-Fi, it will be able to track down your location, though not very accurately, but satisfactorily enough. Next is the aspect ratio. Because of this particular aspect ratio, as they have directly or indirectly tried to compete with iPad mini, some of the games look as if they were crammed into the screen. You can see that in my gaming review. So going on, this particular MIUI version running on Mi Pad has very less customization options. So MIUI is very well known for its customizations and themes, just like the CyanogenMod. But in this particular ROM, there is no customization option. You don't have any themes. So that is one sad part. And it'll only matter you if you really change the themes. And definitely it's not a big deal. You can live with it. And finally, and I guess this is a major problem for every one of you, that is the heating issue. When I played games, I've seen that the GPU temperature raised up to more than 60 degrees centigrade. So it'll be pretty hot in the back. And so that's pretty much it guys. So these are some of the reasons that you might want to consider buying this device. So let me tell you that for this price, there is no better alternative. And just in case if you want to buy a Mi Pad or a tablet to browse in it, watch the videos and play some games, then this is definitely a tablet for its performance and its great battery life. So that's it guys, thanks for watching the video. If you found this video to be helpful, please give me a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And please subscribe to my channel to see more videos just like this.